Let's display the Amplify Studio-generated React components within our application. First, run your Create React App development server via your command line interface. Keep this running in the background so you can view your application changes in the browser. Once your server is running, go to the app.js file. Clean out what's there now and replace it with a React fragment. I'll also delete the imports. First, let's add the navbar component to our app. First, import it. And then create an instance of it. When you view the navbar in the browser, you'll notice that it doesn't span the whole page. Let's change the width to make sure that it takes up the whole page. Now let's add the Note UI collection as well. So first import it and render it on the page. Now you'll notice that all of the notes render and 9 at a time. You'll see that this search bar is a little bit hidden by the navbar. Let's add a margin to the bottom of that navbar. In the index.css file, let's add some custom CSS to make the app look even better. I'll create a container, add margin 0 auto, and the max width to 900 pixels. I'll also add some CSS for a modal. I'll want my forms to not always render on the page. I'll want to only show them sometimes. So I'll put them on a modal so that I can show and hide them. The position will be absolute. It'll be white with a gray border. There will be a margin left and margin right on it. And then I'll position the width, left, right, and top. Back in here, I'll wrap that Note UI collection in the container. You'll see that the delete button already works. And then I'm going to create two modals that have the create note and the update note in them. I'll make sure to import the create note form IntelliSense is doing it for me within VS Code, but they are imported. And now you'll see that I have both my modals stacked on top of each other right here. I'm going to hide both just for the time being. We've now created the basic user interface for our application.